previously on the Chibbleist the Month Show.
Don't ask me why, but I strongly suspect we're going to need them to get the others back.
So, you want Maul to babysit?
Fine.
Woohoo! Welcome to the Babysitter's Club, bitches. Nanny Rose is on the job.
What's wrong with me? What's wrong with me? Well, let me think, Professor. Oh, yeah. We've been teleported across the universe into other people's weird bodies to some alternate reality where there's two moons in the sky, dragons flying around, axe-wielding monks offended by swearing, walking tree people, goblins, witches, zombies, and oh yeah, we're on the road to Shambala, which is in the land of Honalee, because we're off to see a wizard!
So now we have a talking, mutated snollygoster, a schizophrenic supercomputer, and a helicopter mom with serious anger management issues on the team?
Correction, a seriously angry helicopter mom who is in charge of the team.
There's the docs.
Is anybody gonna make the Mos Eisley reference?
What's that?
Wretched hive of scum and villainy? Come on! You guys suck!
Blazes? It's locked.
Wouldn't that be normal for a maximum security enclave bunker?
Don't be ridiculous. It's always open. Modus lives for company.
Try the intercom.
Can I help you?
It's Karen White. I'm here to see that two-timing, ass-kissing, cheating weasel. He's expecting us.
Who?
Justin Gentry.
Oh. President-elect douchebag.
Yes, him.
Sorry, Ms. White, but I have been instructed to inform you that President-elect Gentry is not here right now
and will not be available to meet with you during this critical transition of power period, which could take up to several months or longer.
What transition of power? There's no current president to transition from.
President-elect Gentry regrets to inform you he's unavailable for the next several months due to the fact that he will be busy overseeing the redecorating of the White House to better reflect his distinctive presidential style and taste.
White House? It's a pile of rubble.
Yes, he's loving the open concept.
I'm warning you, let us in right this instant.
Sorry, have a nice day.
Hey! Get back on the line! Pick up!
No use. That Assaultron is part of Modus's network. It's not going to...
Whitespring Auditorium. 10 minutes. Tell them you're members of the press. This'll be a hoot.
Look! Press passes.
Deeds on Anderson Cooper. Ooh, this is nice. I hope I'm not underdressed.
MODIS is broadcasting the inauguration worldwide, so be sure to ask the most stupid and compromising questions you can think of. And refer to Justin as MODIS POTUS, or Mini MODIS, or MODIS Light, or MODIS Light in the loafers.
So what do you think of this, Mr. MODIS? I open up with one of my best jokes, you know, the one where a cultist, a raider, and a mole miner walk into a bar and...
Absolutely not. You will do precisely what we practiced and read the script exactly as it is written. Doing so will prevent any painful electric shocks from the diodes I've had surgically implanted in your body.
Implanted diodes? I thought those makeup artists were being a little invasive.
On you. In 3, 2...
My fellow Americans, a cult...
What the?
Ow! I'm reading it?
Oh, yes you are. Sorry.
A culture of change is upon us. A bright new day dawns. America is reborn.
Justin Gentry!
Karen, how did you... Ow!
Get your skinny little ass off that stage right now. You're going to help us find Chip.
Please be seated. At the conclusion of the inauguration, you'll be permitted to ask one pre-approved question.
What? One question?
Overruled! I have one question and I'm gonna ask it now.
Question not approved.
Jesus Christ! Holy...
Victoria, this is not...
Let him have it!
This is going well.
My question, how old does one have to be eligible to become President of the United States?
Oh, that's an easy one. 35.
Correct, Mr. President-Eject. And judging by the zits all over your stupid face, the peach fuzz on your chin and your general cluelessness, I'm guessing you're about 18 years too young for that job. I, on the other hand, am a vivacious 37.
37?
73, maybe.
My ass.
Vivacious as a prom queen.
Vivacious as a bouquet of fresh roses.
That and the fact that I got the second most write-in votes makes me the actual legal president. Step aside, Justin Dweeber.
Minus just reminded me I'm actually 51.
What?
Yeah, I only look young thanks to Chipmunk.
What the fuck are you talking about, you big-eared moron?
He bit me.
What?
Yep, I remember like it was just yesterday.
Gosh darn it, Justin, give me that back! And it is not a purse, it's an official Pioneer Scout sling pack! Now
say
give it back!
Say it!
Oh, jeepers, fine! I'm just a lowly tadpole, and I bow before the greatness that is possum rank Justin Gentry.
Good job, bald boy.
What did you say?
Good job, bald boy. Boy.
Take it back! Take it back! Ow! 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 I am not Vault Boy!
Ah! He bit me! He bit me! He bitch bit me! Scoutmaster Jaggy! Scoutmaster Jaggy!
Who else wants a piece of me?
Come on, fellas! It's mutant season! Yeehaw! Get the mutants!
Ow! 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 Ow!
Break it up, boys! Now break it up!
Oh, I'm missing teeth!
And I haven't aged a day since.
Ow!
I don't think any of those other guys have either.
You're telling me a bite from chipmunk stops aging?
Yep. Something about his mutant head or some shit.
What?
Well, where the fuck is he now?
Exactly what we're here to find out. Gentry, let's go.
Yes, ma'am.
Hey, get back here.
Come on. They're leaving.
Inauguration in progress? Forget it.
Morons, let's go.
Oh, holy Mothman, Dib. So, who's the president? All right, who's buying? Dib, I bought last time.
I really hate Chipmunk.
I'll do the talking, Scrum. You just stand there and look friendly. I don't want to hear so much as a yar out of you, or you're swimming with the slaughterfish tonight. Got it, you scurvy skeever?
Yar. I mean, I, Captain.
Pardon me. Are you by chance
Captain Horatio Joyfinger? At your service.
Oh, my.
Oh.
Welcome aboard the Wailing Wench.
Whoa, hold on! Wailing Wench? I'm not getting on a whaling ship. Killing whales is not cool, man. It's cruel and illegal. As a standing member of the Save the Whale Society...
Not that kind of whaling, silly little elf boy. Ladies?
Oh, yes.
Oh, my!
Those poor whales!
Right. And this is Mr. Scrum, your cruise director for this enchanting voyage.
Your comfy, cozy cabins are waiting. Right this way, please. Mind your step.
Joyfinger. He's the man with the
tickling touch.
A wench loves much.
Hey, guys, wait for me.
Stop it.
Ow, they started it.
Oh, sorry, pirates first. Those have got to be the dumbest people I have ever met. Oh, that is magical. So good.
Anything about them scream pirates to you?
Not at all. I mean, what pirate ship has a cruise director?
Dude.
Right?
You're a deck elf. The captain wants a word with ya.
Let me go! What's the big idea? Hey, let me go!
Let him go and pick on someone your own size, you pirate scum.
Your own size? Really?
Keep moving!
Ow!
Hey, leave him alone.
Bring him here.
All right, who's it? Ow! Stop it!
Dance for yourself, dance.
Dance? I'll show you dancing. You had enough?
Was that the wind?
And did a seagull just peck me?
Hey, thanks. Still drag your point, my ankle.
I can do this all day.
Enough. All right, me hearties. Time to feed the little elf boy to the sharks.
Yar, there's scarce enough meat on this scabby squeaker to feed a guppy.
Yar, or a tadpole.
Possum!
Well, I hope possums can swim, because it's to Davy Jones's vault with you.
Don't you mean Davy Jones's locker?
Be you deaf? I said vault, boy.
I
boys.
That's right. Chipmunk is in the house.
Holy.
Who's that got me now?
Leave me be! Leave me be!
What? Still hungry?
Come on, up here, bitches! I'll give you seconds! What?
I might have wet myself.
Ha! Finally! Bet you don't have an emergency pair of shorts either! In your face, Citraro!
Spare me! Spare me!
Mind if I borrow your dagger for a minute?
Take it.
What the hell just happened?
A little possum right whoop-ass. That's what.
I think when you have some free time, you might want to review your scout's guide to woodland animals. I don't believe a possum is what you think a possum is.
All right. Nobody move.
No, wait.
And plan B is?
Hold on. Let me put these handsome yet razor sharp claws to use.
All right, Joyfinger. Your ship is ours, and I hereby command you to take us to... where was it that we were going again?
Hawaii?
Havana?
Helvetia?
No, it was...
Honduras?
Something like that, but it was...
It was from that hippie song. Puff the Madre Dragon lived by the sea. Da di da da di di da. The land called...
Honalee!
That's it!
Never will I surrender me ship to the likes
Little
of...
Little Jackie Paper loved that rascal Puff and brought him...
Call off your beast! Call
You're
off your beast!
Come on, grow a pair, man!
Jesus!
Him strings and sealing wax and other fancy stuff! Gosh, what the heck is sealing wax and why the heck would a dragon want it anyway?
Take us to Honalee or we'll feed you to our beast.
Oh, no, sir, no!
No! Spare Captain Joyfinger!
Yes, kind traveler, spare the good captain!
Wait by you, sir!
All right, step aside, wenches. Yes, spare this innocent man!
Really?
Thank you, lass. I owe you me life.
Oh, my!
Man, who smells like a wet dog? Together they would travel on a boat with billowed sails. Jackie kept a lookout perch on Puff's gigantic tail. Golly, what the heck were Peter, Paul, and Mary smoking?
It was the 60s, Chip. It was the 60s. And that wet dog smell, that would be all you. It might be in everyone's best interest if you go below and take a bath.
Aw, jeepers.
Good call, man. Thanks.
Oh, hey, best bud ever.
What's your deal?
Anybody's gonna tell him he's a werewolf?
Nope.
No.
No, nope, 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 nope.
Guys, I think I'm seasick. Think I can hit that guy from here?
Joyfinger! He's the man of a man with a tickling touch. A wench loves much. Oh, yes, that Joyfinger. Pirate king with digits that bring delight all through the night. Ripped for pleasure, one stroke of his hand. A treasure that's at his command. And then you'll know by the bliss that you're wrapped in You have just set sail with Captain Joyfinger. Thief and rogue, I wonder, do you suppose we could see his toes?